On that day, all my earthly treasures. Jesus came and lifted me. Didn't know where to go. I got caught up in listening to their music. Wasn't that good? Yeah. Didn't you enjoy that? Wonderful. Great job. Boy, that was a fast 20 minutes. Well, let's stand. We're going to sing our theme song for the week, Revive Us Again. Amen. Here we go. Oh, hallelujah, thine the glory.
People said, amen and amen. Welcome to week number 2, the Mountain Crusade. Thankful for all that are here, those that are still coming in, and thankful for our parking team and all of the men that are getting us in safely. I want to start tonight from the Word of God. I want to start with Psalm 61. Hear my cry, O God. Attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than thine. For thou hast been a shelter for me and a strong tower from the enemy. I will abide in thy tabernacle forever. I will trust in the covert of thy wings, Selah. For thou, O God, hast heard my vows. Thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. Thou wilt prolong the king's life in his years and his generations. He shall abide before God forever. Oh, prepare mercy and truth, which may preserve him. So will I sing praise unto thy name forever, that I may daily perform my vows. God has been faithful. God has been good. God has been faithful. God has been good. Time and time again, he's proved us to be wrong and that he is always right. And tonight I would ask and I would pray. Are there any believers, any Christians underneath the tent tonight? Would you say amen? Raise that right hand. Say amen like you mean it, that you're on your way to heaven, that your sins have been forgiven, that you're born again and on your way to heaven. Then I would ask you, I would plead with you, that tonight we do not come as spectators. That we do not come looking for some Christian sideshow or Christian entertainment. But that as God's children, God's people, we'd humbly bow ourselves before a 3 times holy God and ask God for grace and for mercy for our churches, for our families, and for this community. I wonder if we could just make Jesus... Are you hearing me tonight? We sow in another place. Hear me now. Don't be here in the methodical and the mundane. I said God's on the move and God's here and God can do great things. I wonder if we'd get our mind off of everything else that's going on in our world. And for just about an hour and 20 minutes at most, put all of our effort and all of our focus and all of our attention on the Lord Jesus. God, the Holy Ghost so is pleased when we make Jesus the main attraction. Let's make Him the main attraction tonight, the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's pray to that end. If you know how to pray, I'd ask that you really pray tonight. Let's ask that the Lord would bless this second week, that God would do things that maybe we don't expect, or maybe that we even think in this day is not possible. I still believe in a God that's able to do great and mighty things, even in 2024. So let's pray to that end. Let's lift our voice. That piano, we're going to just play it real, real soft. And I'm going to turn off my microphone. You're not going to listen to me pray. We're going to pray together. And let's seek God together for just a moment. Let's hit pause on our order of service and our plan and what we expect. And as God's people, let's lift our voice and let's pray. Men to know how to pray, let's really pray tonight. Ask God to meet with us. Holy Father, in Jesus' name, God, to the best of our ability, thy people have gathered here tonight. And Lord, our prayer is that we would come clean before you tonight. God, that you would empty us of self. Lord, that we would pray the prayer of David, that you would search me and that you would try me. And God, that it may not be my brother or my sister or another pastor or another church that's not in the meeting. But God, that if it would be me as the hindrance, God, if I'm the issue, God, if I'm the problem, Lord, that I would be humble and tender enough to the leadership and the power of the Holy Ghost to bow my head and ask for help. And Lord, tonight, that's exactly what we do. God, we bow our head as your people. Lord, we're sorry for where we've made a mockery out of the things of God. Lord, where we've gotten weary in well-doing. And Lord, where we've made church something just mundane, methodical. God, where we just check a box. Lord, tonight we ask you, we plead with you, God, not for the sake of a man, God, not for the sake of a ministry or a church, but God, for the sake of the generation that is to come, God, even this day and this hour, Lord, that you would move and breathe on this tent tonight, God, that every pastor here, God, that you would charge him, Lord, that you would fill him full of faith and full of the Holy Ghost. God, for the pastor that's discouraged and brokenhearted, Lord, that tonight you'd encourage him. God, for the pastor's wife that's holding on by a thread, Lord, who is hurting in her heart and is in a difficult season. God, bless that dear lady. Encourage her tonight. Bless her ministry of prayer and serving behind the scenes. God, for the choir director, the music director, Lord, whose song has fallen flat, Lord, where there's no more joy and no more gladness, Lord, I pray that tonight you'd move and give that minister of music, God, a song in his heart once again, Lord, that he can remember the old songs of Zion and why he sings what he sings. God, for the church member that's gone cold and careless and complacent in their life. God, for the church member who's playing games and playing politics and refuses to bend and bow and to break to the pressure of the Holy Ghost of God. Lord, I pray that tonight a power from heaven would fall in this place and that, God, you'd shake us to the core and that, God, you'd get a hold of the church one more time before Jesus comes. And God, in just a few minutes, when this man of God that you've sent us for this day and this hour, God, when our pastor, Pastor Ralph Sexton, God, when he comes behind this pulpit tonight, God, I pray from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet, God, that you'd anoint him in power. God, that he would have strength of body, clarity of mind, and a message from heaven. God, from your mouth to our ear, would you speak to your people tonight and use your man. God, give him what he needs. Lord, I pray that you do something supernatural. Something supernatural. Lord, that no man could get glory. God, that no movement could get glory. But that God, you'd get all the praise. That God, you'd get all the glory. And that, Lord, you'd be honored in everything that's done for thy sake. Lord, we love you. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you for the power of prayer. We thank you for the Holy Ghost. God, our Father, you're a good Father. You're tender, you're loving, you're long-suffering. And God, you're good to us. We thank you for East Tennessee. God, for all these churches that have gathered, all these pastors, these people. Bless us tonight. In the name of Jesus, we agree together. Amen and amen. Now, here's what we're going to do. Don't sit down yet. Unless you have a physical ailment, you need to sit. Please sit. But if you're physically able, would you stand to your feet all over the tent tonight? Brother Arthur's going to come. And we're going to sing Revive Us Again one more time. From the top to the bottom, we're going to sing the whole song, but we're going to sing it like we mean it. Not just another tune that we've heard 1,000 times, but from a heart that's truly desperate for revival in these days. Let's sing to the Lord tonight. Let's ask God to do what only he can. Brother Arthur, you come, lead us in song. People said,
I've had a song on my heart all day long, and especially this verse right here, and I want you to help me sing it. Have thine own way, Lord. Have thine own way. Hold o'er my spirit. Hold o'er my spirit. Absolute sway. Absolute sway. Fill with the Spirit. Till all can see. Till all can see. Christ only. Christ only. Always living. Have thine own way. Don't sing it to me, sing it to him. Have thine own way. Oh Lord, my spirit, absolute sway. Till all shall see. eyes closed. Y'all almost got it. One more time. Have thine own way, Lord. Have thine own way. Oh, Lord, my feet.
Ooh, we got to give it to him.
Have some
God's people said, amen. Amen. You can be seated. Well, again, it's a privilege to be here tonight, to be starting this second week of the Mountain Crusade. And we want to say thank you to all of our friends who have made up a special group of prayer warriors and friends of the ministry. A very special trip to South Korea just a few years ago. And Pastor Roy Yelton and the men that went, all of those men that are here, the pastors and the men, I want you to stand, please, tonight. Be recognized. Thank you for being here tonight. We love and appreciate you. God bless you. It's a very, very consequential trip. Changed my life, and I know it changed the life of these men forever. And Pastor Ralph will talk a little more about that in a few minutes. But one of the men in ministry that got to go with us and to be a part of that special crusade in Korea was Brother Larry Madden. And I love Larry Madden. I've loved Brother Larry all my life. All my life. I don't want to tell any tales out of school, but I love and appreciate his heart for the Lord. He's got a song for Jesus. He really does. And I'm thankful for his tenderness. He's a songwriter. He's a minister of music. He's a prayer warrior. He's a fantastic husband. He's a friend of this ministry. And I want him to come tonight to sing a song that's on his heart. Brother Larry, you come.
There we go. This is a new song. Brother Winston couldn't have set it up any better than he did. If you ever questioned the goodness of God, I dare you go back when he found you, wherever you was, he found you, when you weren't even looking for it. If you want to go back even further, when he was on that cross, and he saw us, he saw me. How can we not say God is good? Amen. He is a good, good God. When I was lost, you came and found me. When I was blind, you let me see. When I was searching for something so long, you carried me home. Lord, you've been good, so good to me. Lord, you've been good, so good to me. The way that you love me is more than I can imagine, and I'm only starting to see how you've been good, so good to me. You are the freedom from all of my chains. You are my joy, the heart of my faith. You are the only one able to save. Lord, you conquer the grave. Oh, you've been good, so good to me. Lord, you've been so good, so been kind. Lord, you've been good. The way that you love me is more than I can imagine, and I'm only starting to see how you've been good. So good to me. Lord, you've been good. So good to me. Oh, you've been good. So good to me.
Wow. Thank you, Brother Larry. The last time we were together, you were speaking Korean.
That's right.
Not good. Not good, but we had fun. Thank you for being here. And thank all you guys for coming, our prayer team. Sweet and wonderful memories. And careful to give the Lord all the praise, all the glory and honor for what he does with those open doors. We've been praying for area-wide meetings. We've been praying for Newland, North Carolina. They closed Friday night. We've been praying for Weaverville. Brother Watkins, he's here tonight. They're getting ready to go full-time under the tent. Oakboro, North Carolina, and then right here in Johnson City. And then somebody called me earlier and said they're starting a meeting tonight in Irwin, Tennessee. So we want to pray for all of these meetings. And you say, well, why are there so many meetings this year? Everybody knows something's about to happen. And anybody that's got any spiritual sense is starting to pray and say, God, don't leave us like we are. Touch us one more time. And here you are tonight, and I appreciate it. And it's good to have my friends, the Lawsons, here tonight. And Hannah's at school, and you send her my love to Florida. And we're grateful that y'all got to come. And Billy Canoy, you heard me bragging on his daddy last week, what all his daddy did for me and loved on me, Dr. J. William Canoy. And Brother Billy Canoy is a man that loves me and has loved this ministry, and he and his wife Denise are some of my dearest friends. I appreciate you coming up tonight all the way from Greensboro. Amen. Somebody had to chaperone Terry, Brother Terry. So that's a full-time job. Well, I want to just thank you for all the good reports I heard from several pastors. It was my honor to be at Oak Glen yesterday for their homecoming with Pastor Roy. And before we could finish the service, a lady jumped up in the middle of the service, raised up both hands, and said, somebody pray for me. And boy, she hit the altar. And then right behind that was a precious young couple that had been coming to the tent meeting, and they both got saved. And then we had another man get saved. So we had a harvest of souls that people have been around. And I talked to Brother Danny Sykes. He said, y'all had a sweet service yesterday. And I talked to Brother Dwayne Dillard, and he said, God even found them up there in Virginia. And it's just wonderful. And so I appreciate all of you praying, and thank God for the local churches. And that's my burden. Somebody asked Brother Ralph, are you going to preach on prophecy tonight? And I said, well, here's what I'm up against. The Lord's coming, right? And that prophecy's in the book, right? So that's not going to change with me talking about it. He's still coming. And he could come before we get out of here tonight. But my burden is, Brother Terry, for us to get ready for him to come. And so I hope you'll keep praying for me, keep praying for the meeting. My burden last week, you saw what God did with all the pastors. And I told somebody in another state today, down in Georgia, I said, if I look back on those 5 nights, it was a meeting for God's men. It was for the pastors to get fresh oil, fresh encouragement, fresh touch. And then God to touch the people. And here's what I want to ask you to help me pray. I'd like to see God touch the local church. You say, well, Brother Ralph, what about lost people? Well, stay with me just for just a moment. Sometimes we get the cart in front of the horse. And right now, the church is in a desperate state. Churches are closing all over America. And some that have had COVID bad, they're back to 30%, 40%, 50%. And we need revival in that local church. And then if we get revived, then that's going to catch on fire, and we'll start going after our family and friends, right? And that'll produce a harvest. Then if we get some folks saved, then we can bring them back to a church that's on fire with the love of God and the power of the Holy Spirit, instead of bringing them into an ice box. Listen, if God don't move in, you can take a cow down a lot of our churches and she'll give popsicles before she gets to the altar. Amen. We need the power of God and the presence of God. And that is only going to come when the church is revived again. I want to see that for the local church. The local church is God's design. The local church is God's purpose. And we've seen a lot of religious fads over the last 10 years, and they've all faded away. And you know what's happening now? There's some people getting back desperate enough to say, let's get back to the Lord. Let's get desperate. I want to read to you what happens. Look at my notes, how fancy they are. Let me just read to you. This is what happens when a church has revival. As a Sunday school teacher got on fire for God, and she began to pray. And she said, you know what? My Sunday school class is my ministry. And said, it's just not something to take up time on Sunday morning. And she began to pray. She began to take her roll book home during the night, in the nighttime, and lay that roll book down in her prayer place and pray over the students in her class. And boy, she got such a burden that it just wouldn't be Sunday school, but it'd be a time with the Lord for their age group. And that was her broken heart. And you know who she reached in that burdened state of mind? Brother Austin Cook, you know, she was the Sunday school teacher for D.L. Moody. And D.L. Moody got saved. And D.L. Moody becomes a preacher. D.L. Moody starts a Bible college, the Moody Bible Institute. D.L. Moody started a printing press to print tracts and Bibles and study guides, Moody Press. And then he started Moody Broadcasting. Now, one Sunday school teacher, right? And then out of that, he began to go on the road and preach to thousands. And we saw young people get saved, surrender to preach. And while Moody was preaching overseas in England, he told the story of his Sunday school teacher. And guess what happened? Another Sunday school teacher in England, she got a burden. And she heard that story. And she began to pray and fast over her Sunday school class. And then she went and told her pastor one Sunday, every student in my class has been saved. They're all born again. And she told the preacher and said, preacher, I want you to go hear this man that stirred me up for my class. Her pastor was F.B. Meyer, and who wrote all those wonderful books. And F.B., he said, you know what I've heard about him? And this is from F.B.'s mouth. And Pastor Meyer said, I'm just really not too impressed. And he wouldn't go. He had heard he was a little bit rowdy, a little, you know, wasn't as stoic as the British brethren. And so finally, she kept praying and she kept talking to him, said, Pastor, you got to go. And finally, he goes to hear D.L. Moody. And in that service, God broke the heart of F.B. Meyer and gave him fresh oil, fresh anointing, and said, we got to go after lost people. It doesn't matter if they're children, if they're teenagers. And he started preaching like never before with a new passion. And so F.B. Meyer got invited to come to America to preach. And so he's up in New England. I believe his first meeting was in Massachusetts, if I'm not mistaken. And in that service, a young man surrendered to preach. a man that had been wrestling with it, like what happened in Newland last week. That man had been wrestling for weeks and months about surrendering to preach. And on Thursday night, he dialed in, amen? Well, this man dialed in, and he got right, and he surrendered to preach, and his name is Wilbur Chapman. And Wilbur Chapman got saved and surrendered to preach. And then Chapman goes out into evangelism with the Chapman evangelistic team. And they went all over America preaching the gospel. And they were in Chicago, Illinois on a weekend, and the White Sox had a day off. And a young ball player came to hear Chapman preach. And his name that got saved that day was none other than Billy Sunday, a White Sox ball player. And he got saved. And he surrendered, left the ball field, left fame, left fortune, and he went to preach the gospel. And he started traveling with Wilbur Chapman. And then, you know what? Chapman then is taking a large church. People were talking to him, said, you need a home base. He took that church. So Billy Sunday went out on his own into evangelism. 1924, there's a crusade, and there's a prayer group in Charlotte, North Carolina, with a bunch of businessmen. Men that just were from different parts of the city, community, and state, but they had a burden to pray for the local church, had a burden to pray for revival. And in 1924, those men became backers and financial supporters, and guess what they did? They prayed for 8 years after that Billy Sunday meeting, and in 1932, those same men, out of that meeting of Billy Sunday, they invited Mordecai Ham to come to Charlotte, North Carolina. And the power of God moved in Charlotte. It got in the schools, it got in the high school, and there was a young man, 17 years old, he kept coming, came for a night, and then came back another night, and conviction got a hold of him. And Billy Frank got saved, a 17-year-old boy, in that meeting. You know him as Billy Graham. And he got saved in that meeting. Oh, yeah. And in 1973, that boy that got saved under the preaching of Mordecai Ham traveled to Seoul, Korea. And that one night, 1.1 million people are standing outside for somebody to preach the gospel. And Billy Graham can't speak Korean, but he reached over and tapped a young man on the shoulder by the name of Billy Kim. And Billy Kim preached that night with anointing and power as hundreds came into the kingdom of heaven. All because a Sunday school teacher had a burden for revival in a wrong class. Ushers, you come. If you believe what God's doing, I want you to give tonight. You can help underwrite this meeting. This is not sponsored by any group. It's just the local churches in this area. And if God's spoken to you and you want to help, you can write a check to RSM. And if you're watching online, you can now give online. They've got it in place for this meeting. So it'll be there for the Johnson City Crusade, or what we're calling the Mountain Crusade right here in East Tennessee. We'd love for you to come and be a part by giving and participating with us is only you can do. So I hope that you'll just pray about what God would have you to do tonight. Brother Terry Roberts, would you come to the platform? And Brother Terry's been working hard. He's been helping our dear friends at Newland, and then he's been helping here and getting us ready. And our good friend, Brother Daniel Buchanan, got to come tonight. And he's leading the prayer team for us tonight. We appreciate Brother Daniel. Brother Roberts, would you lead us in prayer for the offering, buddy? They get you a mic good. All right. Love you.
Boy, ain't it good to be under the tent once again, Johnson City. Let us pray. Father God, we come to you tonight as humbly as we know how, God. Honoring you and glorifying you. God, the word we heard from Brother Ralph, how one can make a difference. God, we want to all do that as Christians. We should all have the desire to be one that wants to make a difference. God, everybody's not going to be on the platform. Some are going to be behind the scenes. But it takes everyone to be a members of God's great body. And God, they're all important, God. And God, this offering's important. God, we can't put on a meeting like this unless that you finance it. And God, you always use your people. And God, I pray tonight, God, as they pass the buckets, God, everything that's dropped in that bucket, God, we're believing in you that you can multiply it. God, you may have somebody in here, God, that wants to finance a lot of it. And God, you may have some in here that just has a few cents or has nothing. But God, we all want to be a blessing. And I know you want to bless your people. So you bless those that have to give abundantly. God, you have them that you bless them that don't even have nothing to give, because you're God. And God, we ask you, Lord, when the man of God comes, that you touch him and you feel him, God, tonight. Preach him in power. And as our friend Daniel Buchanan says so many times, God, when the church starts loving on you, babies start being born. God, we're looking for that in this second week in Johnson City. But God, we can't do it unless you show up and you be with us. But God, we're going to glorify you and honor you and praise you because of what we've already felt under the tent. Now be with us in Jesus' name. Amen.
Count for something to leave their marks when life is through, but vain pursuits will count for nothing. Time will erase whatever we do.
Lord, my life to count for Jesus, for earthly
inside my heart, there burned the question, what was I placed on earth here for? It truly
no need to add to worldly riches.
I only seek eternal gain.
No need to add to worldly riches.
I only seek eternal gain.
Just need someone to talk to. He's always there to hear my prayer each time I call him. Every need he will supply my thirsty soul. He'll satisfy.
He's all I need. with us tonight. Christ is all I need. Christ is all I need. Jesus, Jesus is all I need. Christ is all.
Brother Terry, just stay right there, would you? A few hours ago, I prayed with a pastor in Georgia. And he said, Brother Ralph, he said, I don't think I've ever had such a dark day. I said, what's up? He said, since you were down here about 6 months ago, he said, it seems like it, everything in my health is just gone. They had to call somebody in to do the pulpit. He said, I can't even hardly walk. And he said, I was reading the Bible yesterday, and he said, a Bible verse just set me on fire. And then he said, well, I can't wait to Sunday to preach. And then I thought, I can't. My heart's not working. My kidneys aren't functioning. And he said, it's just like inside of me, I've never wanted to preach so much. But I can't. But he said, he's all I need. I don't know why I'm going through this, but I know that God's going to help me through this. I went by the house of Dr. James Alexander Stewart before he died. And Dr. Stewart had a very severe case of MS. And he'd just sit and rock. He'd lost down to about 100 pounds. And he'd just sit in that rocker and he just rocked. And I came by, wrote all those books on the power of the Holy Spirit, all those books on revival. And I said, Doc, before I left to go preach today, I wanted to come by and say hey to you, Miss Ruth. I saw his little lips moving. And I couldn't hear him. I got down on my knees beside his chair. I put my ear up to his lips. You know what he was saying? He was saying, I must preach. I must preach. I must preach. The old body was gone. The tabernacle was wasted away. But there was a volcano inside of him. And he wanted to preach the word of God. Listen, church, if we don't get back to being in love with Jesus, we're not going to have church. We're losing the country. We're losing our kids. Hey, we're going through the motions week after week. Until somebody gets a burden. Until somebody says, he's all I need. You don't have to worry about peer pressure. You don't have to worry about what the guy's doing in his church down the road. You got to get revival. You got to have the power of God. And you may be here today with a burden, a broken heart, a sick body, financial disaster. Your kids are breaking your heart. Your grandchildren are out in the world. He's that comfort. He's that one. I want you to sing it again. Listen, God's already spoken to somebody. There's somebody here. You're not even saved. Jesus comes tonight. God had you under this old tent. There's a prodigal son here tonight. There's a prodigal daughter here tonight. But boy, God's speaking to his preachers. He's speaking to these Sunday school teachers. Let's ask God to do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. You just mind the Lord. We're going to just open this old-fashioned altar. If God's moved in, there ain't no sense of me getting in the way. You just be tender-hearted to the Holy Spirit.
He's all I need when I just need someone to talk to. He's always there to hear my prayer each time I call him. Every need he will supply my thirsty soul. He'll satisfy. He's the Lord of all.
Is he your Lord of all?
And he's all.
Is he Lord of all for you, Sunday school teacher? Is he Lord of all for you, youth worker?
When I'm weary.
Are you weary? Do you need fresh oil?
Every
break out of that old chair and find you a place to pray.
My deepest longing, time and time again. He's my soul's inspiration, my heart's
mama,
consolation.
Daddy,
he's my everything.
When's the last time your baby
he's
saw you in the altar? When's the last time they heard you at the house saying, he's all I need?
He's all I need.
Pastor, do you need fresh oil? Do you need fresh anointing?
Any other, for he's a friend that's closer than any brother.
He's that friend.
And on this friend, I can rely to as life goes by. He's the Lord of all. He's all I need. He's all I need. I dare not turn to any other, for that's closer than
some of you youth workers, gather around those teenagers and pray. Some of you preachers, get in here in the altar and pray for the meeting. God's got us in an intersection tonight. Just mind the Holy Ghost.
As life goes by, he's the Lord of all, and he's all I. Comforts me when I'm weary. He's his every pain, feels my deepest longing. Time and time again, he's my soul's.
Christ is all. Is he all you need? Just keep minding God.
Jesus is all.
Are you clean before the Lord? You say, Brother Ralph, I can't kneel. Come and stand in that altar. You burdened over your children? Come and stand and have a prayer for them. You burdened over your church? Come and pray. Well, pray for your pastor. You just mind God.
For he's a friend. A friend that's
today's an intersection for somebody.
Brother,
Holy Spirit's changed the whole service.
And on this friend, I can rely to be my strength. As life goes by, he's the Lord of all.
Yeah.
He's all. When I'm weary, Jesus, every pain fills my deepest longing. Time and time again, he's my soul's inspiration.
Brother Terry Waters, I want you to come and pray. They're going to sing another verse. Listen, you better come and mind the Lord. Brother Nicky, would you come? Brother Nicky Waters. Heads are bowed, hearts are tender. Please don't grieve the Holy Spirit. You say, Brother Ralph, I've been saved 50 years. You can still grieve the Holy Spirit by not being obedient. Your church has been in revival. God's been there moving. You pray.
Amen. Let's pray. Ever been a day we need you to breathe on us. Oh God, oh, would you breathe on us one more time, God? Oh, we have to have you, God. Come on, breath of God. Breathe upon us, Lord. God, as you have done in the days of old. God, just one more time. Oh, God. Gave David one more drink from the well of Bethlehem. God, would you give us one more touch, oh God? God, I pray you breathe on us in such a way, oh God. God, our families will never be the same. God, our churches will never be the same. The workplace will never be the same. God, the drug dealers will never be the same. God, the bars will never be the same. The city park will never be the same. God, the schools will never be the same, God. God, we need you to come like you did in Hezekiah's day, just suddenly, oh God. Tear down strongholds, God. God, we need you to break the chains of sin, of rebellion, of ungodliness. God, it's sin revival, oh God. Oh God, would you tear down, God, the strongholds, God, around our lives, God, around churches. Oh God, help us to see. God, we need each other. We need you, God. Lord, I love you. I praise you. God, thank you for rescuing me, oh God. Oh God. Lord, I praise your name for who you are. God, I praise you for what you're doing. Lord, we praise you for the cross and the blood, the power of your resurrection. Lord, we bless your name that you're coming again. Lord God, would you revive us in such a way, God, that the world may see and know, God, that you are alive and well. God, that Satan is defeated. God, Lord, that sin has no power. Oh God, I pray in Jesus' name, Lord, you'd help us, oh God, to hear you, to walk with you. Oh God, to serve you like we never have. God, may we just be all in, following you, that you are the one we need. God, we bless your name. God, I thank you, Brother Ralph. God, thank you. God, for what you're doing right now, God. What you're going to do. God, help us to hear you. God, help us to obey you, Father. Most of all, help us to glorify you. Lift up your holy name that you may be seen and glorified in this day and hour. In Jesus' name, amen.
If you're a member of Trinity Baptist Church, if you're on staff at Ralph Sexton Ministries or at the church, or if you're a member of the church, I want you to go over here behind this projector. All the members of Trinity, come out from under the tables, the trailers. If you're able to step away from whatever you're doing, all of the people from Trinity, I want you to meet over here for a second. We're going to pray. 1985, God sent a great move to the Kingsport area. Did some incredible things that we're still talking about even today. God sent you an evangelist to this area. Gave him great favor. Used him in power. He gave God all the glory for it then. He still does now. And we're still rejoicing in what the Lord did in 1985. And I'm thankful for those stories. I'm thankful for those of you that got saved in 1985. Those of you that got called to preach in 1985, for the churches that branched off, some that even started out of that meeting in Kingsport, those many weeks that went on. But dear friends, with all the love in my heart, Kingsport's not enough. 1985 was a long time ago. I'm 34 years old. I wasn't alive in 1985. And I still believe in the same God that moved in 1985 is the same God that's alive and well tonight. The last message of that meeting, if I look at all the records that we have correctly and the testimony of the people that were there, the last message that night was the end has come and God is gone. In that meeting, there's no telling what could all have been if people had just been obedient. Not here to blame, not here to point fingers. But I am here to say tonight that there is an end. There is an end to what God's willing to do in a generation. And what if tonight, a seemingly inconsequential Monday night of a second meeting that maybe you didn't even really want, what if this is your last chance, this side of heaven, to do serious eternal business with God? What if this is your last opportunity? You say, I don't believe it's my last opportunity. Well, that's between you and the Lord. But you hear me tonight. God wants to do business in this place. God sent us a man for decades. He's been faithful to teach and preach the word of God. We've heard a lot of good messages and we've heard a lot of good singing in our day. We're founded on the goodness of God, I'm afraid. What if tonight was the last night? What if this was the last night of this meeting? Would we treat it a little differently? God's here, and he wants to do business. So maybe we just need to be still, get along with God. Maybe it's not my brother, maybe it's not my sister, but maybe for the first time in a long time, we'd be willing to admit, it's me. I'm the problem. I'm the issue. Let's ask the Lord to search our hearts. We're going to go over here. Our church is going to gather. We're going to pray. Pastor Ralph is our pastor emeritus. We love him. We appreciate him. We got a heart for him. And we're going to gather together and pray. You mind the Lord. They're going to play softly. Nobody's going to sing. Just the music's going to play softly. Pastor Ralph shared his heart. We're just going to pray. If we really want God tonight, let's go get him.